Hi guys, Harbs Arbs here. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Guild, a criminal organisation in the city of Baldur's Gate that we can find references to in Baldur's Gate 3 Early Access. Okay, let's go. So, one of the references we can find to the Guild are in the small tiefling hideout within the Druid Grove. It kind of gives off some Oliver Twist, kids pickpocketing you type vibe.
Anyway, you want to talk? Talk.
You got to pick a pocket or two.
But inside we can find a book entitled The Guild, Hidden Rulers of Baldur's Gate. But before we get into the contents of the book, who are the Guild? In Descent into Avernus, we can see the following description. The organization, known simply as the Guild, unites cutpurses, loan sharks, killers, thugs, con artists, grave robbers, cat burglars, and every other type of criminal in the city. The Guild operates under the noses of the Watch and the Flaming Fist, by adroitly keeping its illicit activities quiet. Each city neighborhood falls under control of one or more kingpins, crime bosses who report to the head of the Guild. These kingpins style themselves as elite criminals, often adopting memorable nicknames and distinctively decadent dress. Scores of common criminals work beneath each kingpin, with the most competent and cutthroat members rising to favored status. Many members of the Guild are deplorable members of Baldur's Gate society, but it is a reflection of the city at large. Petraea families are quite willing to pay Guild members to plant incriminating evidence on rival family properties, and whilst the criminal activities of the Guild are kept to a minimum in the upper city due to the vigilance of the Watch, members of this guard can often be bribed by kingpins. The Flaming Fist are arguably less corruptible, but they are often spread extremely thin to pay enough attention to guild activities, although when they do, they certainly give a certain vigour and passion to crime fighting.
I am the law! Every crime must be punished! I serve the Flaming Fist!
So, the book that we can find in the Tiefling Hideout focuses on a woman called Rilsa Rael. She is a lieutenant to the guild leader Nine Fingers Keen, but we'll talk about Nine Fingers in a bit. Rilsa is one of the kingpins of the guild, and the book states that in another time and place that she would be celebrated as a revolutionary. Unfortunately, her life took a different path, and at a young age, she was orphaned when her father was hanged by the Flaming Fist for sheltering his fugitive brother, whilst her mother was denounced by a jealous wife of a Petraea and imprisoned in the Sea Tower, where she perished. Rilsa believed that the society of Baldur's Gate was unethical, and therefore she had a duty to act outside of it, hence how she fell into the arms of the guild, where she rose up to become a kingpin, operating out of the Kalimjul Emporium, located in Little Kalimshan, a small walled district in the outer city situated here. We can see further detail about Rilsa's position in the guild in the adventure Murder in Baldur's Gate. Rael actually gained a foothold in Little Kalimshan due to her Kalashite and Tetherian parentage, which meant her language skills gave her a natural advantage in bringing Little Kalimshan under the guild's influence. However, it was her talent at going unnoticed and her skill with a knife that earned her a position on the ladies' court as one of Nine Fingers' bodyguards, and from there her promotion to Little Kalimshan's kingpin. It is presumed that she is the heir to the guild leadership. The reason why the book talks of Rael being a revolutionary in another time and place is because of her Robin Hood-esque attitude towards the guild. Unlike many of the members of the guild who would selfishly hoard the wealth they acquire in the city, Rael is described in Murder in Baldur's Gate as follows. She moves openly through the outer city, alternating between helping the poor, slinging insults at fist patrols moving between Worms Rock and the lower city, and occasionally breaking the nose of a reluctant shopkeeper. She holds a public audience at her headquarters in the Kalimjul Emporium to hear the complaints of outer city residents. At the end of the book on Rilsa, it says the following. At her Garden of Whispers, information can be shared with the guild anonymously. Anyone with a grudge to bear or a competitor to bring low, that is to say, anyone of importance, can ensure that the whole city knows their grievance. It is said that if somebody speaks of your weak spot in the garden at dawn, you can expect to find a knife buried in that exact spot before night falls. In Descent into Avernus, the Garden of Whispers is described as a maze of wood and paper screens, where people from across the city can buy and sell secrets with guild agents and each other, speaking through the barriers so as to maintain anonymity. It is my belief that we'll be able to visit Little Kalimshan when we get to the city of Baldur's Gate. We can clearly see it on the world map in this area of the outer city. This bluish building here appears to have domed roofs, just like the traditional buildings of the faraway land of Kalimshan, of which Little Kalimshan's design is based upon. So I've spoken about Rilsa, but who is her boss, Ninefingers? Outside the blighted village, we can find a deceased courier called Gomwick. We can find a letter on his person that says the following. Ninefingers, I won't come back to the city, not while you have your thugs looking for me. If you want the debt paid, you'll have to trust me and collect it yourself. Go to the graveyard and look for where a M. Kerwin is buried. Get digging and you'll find enough valuables to settle matters between us. Don't go looking for me. I'll know when I'm safe. S. This letter perhaps shows the true side of the Guild, a ruthless organization that inspires fear. Ninefinger's real name is Astell Keen, and she is described in Murder in Baldur's Gate as someone who disdains flashy garb and appearance-improving magic, so the world sees her as she truly is, an unassuming brunette woman of middling height and build. Neither plain nor beautiful, Ninefingers is completely indistinctive. This apparently helped her in her early life as a thief. She is apparently a shrewd judge of people and never forgets a name. Her nickname Ninefingers is how most people in the city know her, but the story behind it is quite tragic. When she was only 5 years old, a one-eyed elf kidnapped her and sliced off the little finger of her left hand and sent it to her parents with a huge ransom demand. In an act of revenge in later life, Ninefingers tracked down the elf and blinded his remaining eye and cut off all but the little fingers on both of his hands. Finding out that the elf had an addiction to Sable Moonflower, she bought the smoking house that the elf attends and has ensured that all of the moonflower in which he smokes is laced with the yolk of cockatrice eggs, which will ensure that the elf has vivid nightmares every time he smokes it. Because Ninefingers knows that the elf will likely outlive her due to his natural heritage, she has paid someone to continue to put cockatrice eggs in his moonflower for the rest of his life, so that the elf is in an inescapable position where he needs the moonflower to ease his addiction, but every time he smokes it, he will have these horrifying nightmares. So yeah, don't mess with Ninefingers. I can't even imagine what she would have done if he'd chopped off both of her little fingers. Ninefingers rose up through the guild to become its leader due to her patience and ability to calculate and exact revenge against those who cross the guild. She is a meticulous planner and will go as far as to pit guild members against each other if it means subduing an internal threat. In Baldur's Gate, there exists sanctioned and unsanctioned crime. If someone is paying protection money to the guild and a gang of criminals then robs that shop, then Ninefingers will want to know who did it. In order to minimize interference from the Watch and the Flaming Fist, Ninefingers has invested her substantial wealth in numerous legitimate businesses, as well as paying off various politicians, betrayers, judges, and officers. However, in Murder in Baldur's Gate, it is made clear that Ninefingers still fears the Flaming Fist and does not want an open confrontation with them, even if she is now powerful enough to manipulate votes in the Parliament of Peers. Recently in Descent into Avernus, there has been a populist tide against her organization. There is a rise of vigilantes on the streets of Baldur's Gate that are actively hindering the guild's activities. One specific part of Descent into Avernus says the following. After a carefully coordinated attack on a Petraeus estate fell to pieces when a vigilante clumsily alerted the estate guards, Keen declared open season on do-gooders of all stripes. I imagine that this letter held by Gomwick will lead us to a graveyard in Baldur's Gate, and it is very likely the same graveyard in which we will find the Tsar Mansion, the family linked to Astarion's vampire master, Cazador. I have a feeling that we will almost definitely come across Ninefingers in Baldur's Gate 3, and the story may present us with some very morally ambiguous quest directions. Anyway, thanks for watching guys, if you enjoyed this video then do please give me a like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye!